Guys, myself MD Tarek Anwar. I am working as an assistant professor in Mechanical Engineering Department at St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management, Gurugram. Today, I am going to deliver a lecture on the topic that is series and parallel connection of pipes. What do you mean by this? That is, pipes are connected in series or pipes are connected as parallel connection. An equivalent length of pipe, an equivalent diameter of the pipe. If we will change this series and parallel pipes into another pipe, or you can say in single pipe. So this is the today topic. I am going to deliver a lecture of radio lecture series, lecture number 21, unit number 3, on the topic which I have already explained. So I will discuss what is pipe in series. Pipe in series means there are connection in series one after another. So pipe 1, pipe 2, pipe 3. Q is the discharge through pipe. So considering Q1 is the discharge through pipe 1, Q2 is the discharge through pipe 2, Q3 is the discharge through pipe 3. So what we will get, that is Q1 is equal to Q2 is equal to Q3 is nothing but is equal to Q, because from initial stage Q is the discharge which is passing through the pipe which are in series. So we can write, or you can say, that is Q is the discharge through pipe. Now we will calculate head loss. Head loss we will get by the formula of head loss. So total head loss, or we can say head loss, total head loss is nothing but head loss in the pipe 1 plus head loss in the pipe 2 plus head loss in the pipe 3 plus, and so on. And agar 4-5 hai, 5 pipe hai, 6 pipe hai, to head loss will be added, but discharge will be same. So if we want to change the pipes which are in series into equivalent pipe, means that 3 pipe, 4 pipe ko hum ek pipe mein convert karna chahte hain, so that total value will be same. Iske liye kya method hoga? This method is only for series. Sorry. So see this diagram again, Q1, Q2, Q3. So we will converting this pipes which are in series into equivalent pipe. Equivalent pipe means it is denoted by length of equivalent pipe LE and diameter of equivalent pipe DE. So what will be the formula and what is the method to derive this expression? Before that, I'll read this definition or explain this definition here. A pipe of uniform diameter is said to be equivalent to a compound pipe. Clear? Uniform diameter ka pipe lena, a new pipe is said to be equivalent pipe. Kiske? A compound pipe which are in series. If it carries same discharge and also encounters same loss. Kab hoga ye equivalent pipe? अब जिस चार्ज भी सेम निकल रहा हो, जैसे सीरीज पाइप के थ्रू आ रहा था, और लॉसेस भी सेम हो रहे हो, सो दिस टाइप ऑफ पाइप इज नोन एज इक्विवेलेंट पाइप. आई हैव शोन हियर, दिस इज इक्विवेलेंट पाइप. क्यू इज द डिस्चार्ज, क्यू इज द डिस्चार्ज इन द अबव केस ऑल्सो, बट इन दिस केस लेंथ ऑफ इक्विवेलेंट पाइप चेंजेस एंड डायमीटर ऑफ इक्विवेलेंट पाइप चेंजेस. मीन्स इन द अपर केस D1 इज different, D2 is different, D3 is different, but here I am considering only one diameter pipe. So you all know that head loss of equivalent pipe is given as F into length of equivalent pipe Q square upon 12 DE. DE means diameter of equivalent pipe raised to 5. So we all know that एच एल इज इक्वल टू गिवन एज एच एल वन प्लस एच एल टू प्लस एच एल थ्री. सो पुटिंग द वैल्यू इन दिस केस दैट इज एच एल इज इक्वल टू एफ वन एल वन क्यू वन स्क्वायर अपॉन ट्वेल्व डी वन रेस टू फाइव प्लस एफ टू एल टू क्यू टू स्क्वायर प्लस ट्वेल्व डी टू रेस टू फाइव प्लस एफ थ्री एल थ्री क्यू थ्री का स्क्वायर अपॉन ट्वेल्व डी थ्री रेस टू फाइव. सो इन प्लेस ऑफ एच एल वी कैन राइट हेयर एफ इंटू एल ई क्यू स्क्वायर अपॉन ट्वेल्व डी ई रेस टू फाइव. सो आफ्टर कैंसिलिंग कॉमन टर्म एफ 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 कैंसल हो जाएगा. ठीक है, क्लियर है. क्यू 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 कॉमन हो जाएगा, वो भी कैंसिल हो जाएगा. 12 से 12 कैंसिल हो जाएगा. रिमेनिंग पार्ट क्या बचेगा, एल ई अपॉन डी रेस टू फाइव इज इक्वल टू एल वन अपॉन डी वन रेस टू फाइव प्लस एल टू अपॉन डी टू रेस टू फाइव प्लस एल थ्री इंटू डी थ्री रेस टू फाइव. दिस इज नोन एज डुपिक्स इक्वेशन. क्लियर. सो इफ इन द क्वेश्चन लेंथ ऑफ ऑल पाइप्स आर गिवन दैट इज एल वन डी वन डी टू डी थ्री लेंथ ऑफ पाइप्स आर गिवन विच आर इन सीरीज एंड वन ऑफ इट इट्स डेटा दैट इज लेंथ ऑफ इक्विवेलेंट पाइप इज गिवन. सो यू कैन फाइंड डी ई दैट इज डायमीटर ऑफ इक्विवेलेंट पाइप विद दिस फार्मूला. सिमिलरली यू कैन फाइंड ऑल्सो लेंथ ऑफ इक्विवेलेंट पाइप इफ ऑल अदर डेटा आर गिवन. सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस पाइप्स इन पैरेलल और यू कैन से पाइप्स आर कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल. क्लियर. सो पैरेलल कनेक्शन इज यूज्ड फॉर इंक्रीजिंग डिस्चार्ज. इस केस में क्या होगा, डिस्चार्ज इंक्रीज करेगा क्योंकि हम क्या कर रहे हैं, नंबर ऑफ पाइप्स लगा रहे हैं इन पैरेलल नॉट इन सीरीज. सो क्यू इज द डिस्चार्ज, फ्लूइड इज फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम ए टू बी बट विद द हेल्प ऑफ टू पाइप दैट इज थ्रो पाइप वन आई हैव मेड क्यू वन और शोइंग विथ क्यू वन. सी दिस डायग्राम, क्यू इज द डिस्चार्ज इनिशियली एंड एट पॉइंट ए पाइप इज चेंजिंग और यू कैन से पाइप इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड इन टू टू सेक्शन और टू पाइप दैट इज पाइप वन एंड पाइप टू. सो टू ब्रांचड. सो फ्रॉम ए टू बी fluid is flowing but with the help of two pipe. So these pipes are in parallel connection. So see another diagram that is which is black in color, pipe 1 A to B through pipe 1, similarly A to B from pipe 2. So you all know that the Bernoulli's equation that is PA by W plus V square upon 2G plus ZA plus PB by W plus V B square upon 2G plus ZB plus HL head loss in the pipeline. Clear. Similarly for the pipe 2, so I am not reading again. So all data are same because pipe is same. So we can write for this case HL1 is equal to HL2 because both the pipes are of similar type or same. So head loss which are occurring in pipe 1, similar is the case head loss which are occurring in pipe 2. So we can write head loss in one case or in one pipe is equal to head loss in pipe 2. Again discharge, see left side of the page, Q is nothing but Q1 plus Q2, already told it is used for increasing discharge. The total discharge which we are getting that is nothing but Q1 plus Q2 and already explained that is HL1 is equal to HL2. So you have to find or we have to find the equivalent pipe for parallel connection. For example, number of pipes which are in parallel connection, you will have to change these pipe into one pipe. So this pipe is known as equivalent pipe. So equivalent pipe for parallel connection, see this diagram, Q is the discharge and A to B fluid is flowing with the help of number of pipe 1 2 3 4 5 6. Clear. There are 6 pipes, length of each pipe is L, D is the diameter of each pipe, discharge through each pipe is Q by L. So you can write q by 6 also, but here I am assuming n number of pipe. So discharge through one pipe is q by n. See another diagram on the right side of this parallel connection for one pipe. From A to B, length of pipe is L, diameter of pipe is D, discharge through pipe 1 is Q by N. In this case, you can write also Q by 6. Clear? So, head loss for one pipe is nothing but FL into Q by N ka whole square upon 12D5, where N number of pipe. Kitne number of pipe ho sakte hain? 6, 8, 12, 15, jo bhi. So, for equivalent length or equivalent diameter, Q is the discharge, which will be same. So, LE is the length of equivalent pipe, D is the diameter of equivalent pipe. So, head loss in this case will be F LE Q square upon 12 DE raised to 5. So, we all know that HL1 is equal to HL2. So, equating of head loss due to in the equivalent pipe and head loss of one pipe. Clear? So we will get the data as FLE Q square upon 12 DE raised to 5 is equal to FL Q square upon N square into 12 D raised to 5. So cancelling the common term, we will get as LE DE raised to 5 is equal to L upon N square D5. Clear? So for this case, length of equivalent pipe is L. Considering the length of equivalent pipe is kitna hai? Length of each pipe, L term will be cancelled out. So we will get final as DE raised to 5 is equal to N square into D raised to 5. After that, DE is equal to N into 2 raised to 2 upon 5 into D. Clear? Because we will here putting the 1 by 5 or root 5 value in this equation. So we will get the answer as DE is equal to N raised to 2 upon 5 into D. So you can also find equivalent diameter of pipe using this formula if all pipes are similar. Clear? Now we'll discuss final part of this series and parallel connection and power transmission through pipes. Clear? See this diagram, I'll explain. Before that, I'll read the formula. This is power theoretical, or theoretical power is given as W into Q into H. This is the basic formula. Or you can write rho G into Q into H. So I am writing only W into Q into H. This is the theoretical formula of power. Actual power is given as WQ into H minus head loss. H is the actual head which is available. Head loss actually kya hoga? There will be some loss. So actual power is given as WQ in the bracket H minus HL. Now we will solve or see this diagram. This is the H which is available. This is denoted by capital H. HL, a small h in suffix HL, head loss due to friction. So actual power is nothing but WQ in the bracket capital H minus small h L. Now we all know that this is the diagram. First of all, we will discuss diagram, then we will derive the expression. So this is the datum head or water head denoted by inverted triangle, ultra triangle. H is the height which is available, pipe in which Q is the discharge through pipe. Q is the discharge through pipe which is exiting and striking on the turbine blades or turbine vanes. So what will be the power which we are getting? Already explained, actual power is given as P actual is equal to WQ and the bracket capital H minus small h L, head loss due to friction. So you know that HL value is FLQ square upon 12 D raised to 5 in terms of Q. Okay? In terms of V, दूसरा फार्मूला होता इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्यू होता एफ एल क्यू स्क्वायर अपॉन 12d^5. सो पुटिंग द वैल्यू एंड मल्टीप्लाइंग द क्यू इन साइड द ब्रैकेट वी विल गेट पी एक्चुअल इज इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू इन द ब्रैकेट क्यू एच माइनस एफ एल क्यू क्यूब अपॉन 12d^5. फॉर मैक्सिमम पावर यू हैव टू मैक्सिमाइज द फार्मूला यू ऑल नो दैट दिस इज मैथमेटिकल रिलेशन दैट इज डी differentiating the equation dp actual upon dq is equal to 0 for maximum power. So after derivation we will get as w outside the bracket. So q value is 1. So 1 into h minus 3 fl q square. Q power kya tha? 3. So 3 q square ho jayega upon 12d^5 is equal to 0. This is the basic math. But W cannot be zero because अगर W zero हो जाएगा तो पूरा whole term zero हो जाएगा तो W zero नहीं हो सकता. So कौन सा term zero होगा for this case? That is H minus 3FL Q square upon 12d^5. So we can write H is equal to 3FL Q square अपॉन 12d^5. वी आर टेकिंग 3 एज ए कॉमन तो एफ एल क्यू स्क्वायर अपॉन 12d^5 इज नथिंग बट हेड लॉस ड्यू टू फ्रिक्शन. सो एच इज इक्वल टू 3h कंडीशन फॉर मैक्सिमम डिस्चार्ज. मैक्सिमा एंड मिनिमा यूज करने के बाद मेरे को क्या पता चला? वी आर गेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ एच इज इक्वल टू 3hL. मैक्सिमम कब होगा? जब h का वैल्यू 3hL के बराबर होगा. नाउ विल फाइंड इफिशियंसी. सो सी दिस फार्मूला. इफिशियंसी इज गिवन एज p एक्चुअल और p थेरेटिकल. थेरेटिकल पावर एंड एक्चुअल पावर. p एक्चुअल इज द एक्चुअल पावर, p थेरेटिकल इज द थेरेटिकल पावर. सो पुटिंग द वैल्यू दैट इज p एक्चुअल इज गिवन एज डब्ल्यू क्यू इंटू एच माइनस एच एल अपॉन डब्ल्यू क्यू इंटू एच. क्लियर? WQ will be cancelled out. We will get as efficiency is equal to H minus HL, small HL, minus upon H. So putting the value of H in this equation, so maximum efficiency kya hoga? Maximum efficiency ke liye condition tha. That is H ka value 3HL hona chahiye. So putting the value of H, that is 3HL minus HL upon 3HL. So after solving we will get maximum efficiency is given as 66.67%. So I am closing the topic today. Bye guys, thank you very much.